It all started when Brian Bass and I went to check out a 79 International Scout 2.
I love the interior.
Yeah, if this thing has one thing going for it, it's the curb appeal. The orange paint, the stripes, it's pretty cool.
It was already cool, but I thought, hey, why not make it a killer, one-of-a-kind car that no one's even had the guts to dream up yet?
What is that?
So I paid $12,500 for it and gave the monkey $75,000 to finish it in 3 weeks to get it done. This is gonna be down, dirty, fast.
So you're not going up, you're going, wanna go down with
it. I wanna get rid of the four-wheel drive. What I had in mind was a sleek, slammed Cali cruiser with the same 70s DNA of the original Scout, but it packs a 707 horsepower Hellcrate engine capable of racetrack speeds. But the monkeys thought we were building a drag car. I did not ever say build a drag car. Who the hell would pay six figures for one of those? But they soon caught on to my idea. Once I had a hard look at those sweet rims from Revo Forge, the custom high-performance chassis from Chris Austin's Chassis Works, and the killer Hellcrate motor, rad. I realized I could probably sell the beast for north of 200 grand, and I would soon call this monster the Scout to Hell.
Ooh, I like the sound of that.
Look at that.
Hey!
How we doing?
Hey, ass monkey.
You gotta come up with a new catchphrase.
What catch?
Ass
you
monkey.
You got the best back.
What does that mean?
That mean I'm the best.
I still don't understand. After 7 years, I don't understand what you're
saying. 7 years?
Ah, Sue. I got no seat.
No seat.
No top.
Okay.
Her custom auto upholstery business and I go way back to the early days of Gas Monkey Garage.
That's hard. $10,000.
Discount.
He gonna pay.
But we haven't seen her much since she priced herself out of the market.
Ass monkey.
Okay, check it out. I need some seats done.
Okay. Rachel called me to come over to look at the seat.
These are the new seats that we're gonna put in.
Okay.
All right. So, for all intents and purposes, what I wanna do is I wanna leave this smooth and rolled over, and this one smooth and rolled over, and then this middle section here, I wanna do in the plaid. We will give you a headrest, but I wanna redo it with nice leather, nice everything.
Yeah.
How much is this gonna cost me? Two door panels, two seats, and carpet for the whole truck.
How much?
Mm-hmm.
I think $5,000.
No way.
Yes way.
Mm-mm.
Yes way.
If you want to do the business, you got to come down to the price that everybody else does.
You got to help Sue sometime.
Come on. You just drove up in a Range Rover.
Come on.
I give it to you for the same price that the other people will do it for, which is, you know, definitely $2,500 or below.
$4,000.
I'm not doing it.
Why is $2,500? That job takes $5,000 to do it, and he being the cheap-ass monkey.
If somebody else will do it for $2,500 and you want $4,000 or $5,000, where would you take it?
He want this, he want that, and he don't... But he don't want to pay. You always treat Sue like that.
No, not really. $2,500.
Come on.
You can do it for $2,500.
Okay, I'll do it.
Okay, cool.
Just good. For ass monkey.
Good.
Just for cheap ass monkey.
That's good. I'm earning my title. I'll bring you the stuff later on today.
This thing is an absolute ton of fab work. This is more fab work than we've taken in a long time. As far as the details and...
I love how they think back there that they got all the pressure.
Oh, yeah.
We're the ones building everything.
It's late.
I mean, oh, I know it's late. That's why everybody's right here.
Well, I see everybody standing around.
It's going to be B.A.
It's going to be badass, but I'm a little pissed off about the time frame.
I mean, yeah, but it's all the details that make a truck badass, really. You know what I mean?
If we make it. I actually coined the phrase that cheap ain't badass and badass ain't cheap. But it does have to be timely.
Go.
Let me break it down for you. I want 200 grand for this Scout, and there's some fresh faces in here that don't really realize what the goal of Gas Monkey Garage is. And it's never changed. Build a car and sell it for the most profit.
Everybody's
over
there.
I get it, I'm not but I am I need it in paint, and I need to sell it.
I know, trust me.
Get it done.
Gary, okay. He's a habitual
I feel like he was
Happy today.
We're getting close to the deadline on the build of our 79 Scout, so it's crunch time. Word around the shop is that Richard's lining up a buyer with some deep pockets. So this buyer may be the golden ticket.
I don't have the car yet, but this is absolutely my favorite part of the build. Today is the day I try to please Richard Rawlings. So I got three different oranges for him to choose from.
And I got two different whites for him to choose from.
Cool vanilla.
I'll lay down the whites first and then mask off the stripes so Richard can see them against the oranges.
Ow! Remember when you were a kid and you got creamsicles and you're like super excited because it was orange flavored popsicle with vanilla ice cream in the middle? It's kind of what I'm going for. I'm going for that.
And then I'll shoot the three oranges. One is color matched to the original factory color, Omaha orange. Tony and I, well, we mixed up the other two.
Daddy liked this one.
We all have our favorites, but the only opinion that really counts is Richard's.
Do you got spray outs or what?
I do. I have you three. These are your factory color and your factory white. I went with a cream just to see what you thought.
That's not factory.
That's factory.
Nah.
Yeah.
That's Tennessee whatever football team. This is whoever beats them most of the time. And
that's factory.
This has got too much brown in it. And that's got too much red. And I don't even know how much that's probably yellow or something.
I don't.
I got to split the difference here.
Okay, so you want me to take some of the brown out and add a little bit more orange to it?
Slight.
Are we compromising right now?
Oh, I'm leaving.
We're compromising, aren't we?
No. Nope,
did we just have a moment?
Not talking to you.
We had a moment, Richard. We had a moment.
That was good. That was good.
No, no, no!
Ollie over the body filler can.
What are y'all doing?
Testing the strength of Bondo.
All right, well, I'm ready to paint, so I'm gonna throw that first color on and then.
Right. We'll let you know how this goes out here.
Don't break a leg.
We'll be here.
After the orange base coat dries, Tony, Keenan, and myself are gonna get busy painting the stripes. That is, of course, if they haven't killed themselves on that damn skateboard yet.
Here, let me get on this side of you, I think.
Here's how you do a perfect kick-ass stripe package. You do it all painstakingly by hand to get the line straight across all three panels. In this case, we're gonna have three colors. We're gonna have the orange from the base coat, tan, and white. See, in the 70s, folks liked their stripes the same way Texans like their chili, beefy and chunky. So we're gonna do a Gas Monkey take on the wide stripe package that came stock on the Scout. The way you create stripes is by masking off the area you want to stripe with fine line tape. The main visible layer will be the white. So that means I'll start by painting the olive tan over the masked orange base coat. The next layer will be the white, since it'll be the most prominent. After that, we peel back all the tape to find a fresh batch of stripes.
Hopefully nothing's wrong.
But before we clear coat, we need Richard to give us a thumbs up.
Oh, you better look scared. Daddy's coming.
I love it when you call yourself Daddy. Look at the other side, it's untaped.
Am I supposed to like it? That doesn't look good. That doesn't look good, that doesn't look good, that doesn't look good, that doesn't look good. I mean, the overall design's fine. We went the stock pattern, right?
Yeah, more or less.
But the lines themselves look like crap.
You do it. I don't even want to talk about this.
Are you that upset?
No, it's just when Richard sees it on TV.
Oh, well, I don't give a So that came in there, right? We knew we had some flaws in the paint that we were going to address before it ever got to clear coat. And of course, he comes in there, and the first thing he finds is all the flaws.
I mean, look at all these little chips.
The thing that's got Richard's panties in a bunch are these tiny little dots on the edge of the stripes, but we're gonna smooth those out anyways. Now we're gonna have to make double sure that all these lines in the stripe package are flawless, or else Richard's gonna come in here and pick it apart all over again.
This sucks. I don't know how you're gonna fix it, but I ain't dealing with it. That ain't coming out of the shop looking like that. Not for the kind of money I'm charging. It's like this. If you just bought a brand new Porsche and you realized the paint was really crappy, well, you'd be pissed off. If I'm gonna be asking north of 200 grand for this bad boy, it's gotta be perfect.
I think he just wants to make it hard.
He does, he's just being a